These youngsters are South Africa's first cricketing representatives to play in Britain since their country's apartheid laws resulted in their exile from the international game in the late 60s. As the two young opening batsmen walked out to the crease, South Africa's absence from the cricket grounds of Britain was over. While South African sides have played here since the boycott was lifted last year, none have been selected as a national squad. Their first opponents on a month-long tour were a daunting prospect. The English under-16 side not only a year older, but considerably larger. But the South African openers stood their ground in the first few overs, and the team were eventually 158 all out. The tour has been a long-term dream for David English, and he's now looking forward to organising a Junior World Cup.
If you go to Wembley and you see the football matches, the England soccer games, you know, you get 60,000 schoolboys shouting for England. I want to do that for the school's cricket. If, you know, this should be on the curriculum.
The visiting players and officials are only too aware of recent violent events in their home country as the political turmoil continues. But today's cricket administrators are keen to point out that their multiracial side at least is pulling in the same direction.
They're wonderful pretenders, you know, they affect a kind of nonchalance and indifference, which I think belies a very, very strong consciousness of the honour that they have to represent South Africa. And I know that at the various functions we've had, I think there have been many lumps in many throats, including mine, may I say.
In the end, a dramatic run chase ended with the English winning by 5 wickets with just 2 balls to spare.